Morning, everyone. Welcome. I'm Pastor Taylor. Welcome to our camp. Our theme this summer is Consider the Birds and the Flowers. This week, you guys are going to be doing some really neat art projects related to birds and flowers. But first of all, we should have three groups this morning. We should have puffins, we should have sandpipers, and we should have pelicans. They're all three seabirds. So where are our puffins? Puffins, why don't we stand up, puffins? All right, welcome, puffins. Good morning. You can be seated. All right, we got our puffins. We should have some sandpipers. Sandpipers, why don't we stand up? Good morning, sandpipers. Welcome. All right, you guys can be seated. We got our puffins. We have our sandpipers. We should have some pelicans. We have any pelicans? Pelicans, please stand up. Good morning, pelicans. Welcome. All right, you guys can be seated. This morning, or this week, we're going to be doing all kind of really neat art projects. We're going to start out, just like we did this morning, you're going to line up with your group outside. So try to remember what group you're in, because we're going to start each morning just like we did. You're going to line up with your group. We're all going to come in together each morning. I'm going to talk to you for a few minutes, okay, from the Bible. We're going to learn a song together. We're going to sing it together. And then every morning, every group is going to do three things. Every day, each group is going to do three things. At some point during the morning, you're going to spend some time in here with Mrs. Taylor, and she's going to talk to you about prayer. She's got a really neat book on how to pray, and you're going to really enjoy it. You're going to have time just with your group, with Mrs. Taylor, and talking about how to pray, and you're really going to enjoy it. Okay? So every morning, you're going to spend some time in here learning about prayer. Every morning, you're going to spend some time in the entryway where you first came through, working on an art project. And every day, at some point, you're going to spend some time back in the fellowship hall working on an art project. So every day, you're going to work on at least two different art projects. And some of them, you'll finish in one day. And some of them will be big projects that you'll work on Monday, and then you'll work on again, and you'll work on again, okay? And if one project doesn't work out the way you want it, or it's not your favorite kind of art, that's okay, because every day, you're going to work on at least two different projects, sometimes three. So by the end of the week, you're going to have done a lot of really, really neat art projects. So again, if one project doesn't turn out just the way you want it, it's okay. It's okay. Because you're going to get a lot of chance to do lots of different kinds of art this week. But I want to start this morning by talking about worry. What are some things that people worry about? Right, raise your hand. What are some things people worry about? Yes, what are some things people worry about?
Not wanting your house on fire.
There you go. Worry about not wanting your house on fire. Some people worry about that. What else do people worry about? Yes? What's that? Okay, yeah, you worry about if your parents are gone. What if they don't come back? Okay, we worry about that. What else do people worry about? Some people worry about money. Okay, what else do you worry about? You ever worry about your pets? Yeah, you worry about your bed. I know you worry about it. What do you worry about, Jack? Why? Like a storm? You worry about a bad storm? You don't want a tree to fall on your house? Okay? Maybe you worry about your family? Okay? Sometimes we don't even know what we're worried about. We just know we're worried. Okay? But I want you to see this morning. Jesus does not want us to worry. Okay? Jesus doesn't want you to worry. One time, many years ago, okay, in the land of Israel, Jesus was up in the mountains. He was up in the hills. A lot of people came to him. They wanted to listen to him. They wanted to learn. And so they lined up on the side of the hill, the side of the mountain, and Jesus talked to them. And it was called the Sermon on the Mount. A very famous sermon where all the people lined up on the mountain, and Jesus talked to them. And he talked to them about a lot of things. One thing he talked to them about was worry. Okay? And there were three things he said to them. Okay? First, he said, whatever you love the most, whatever you really love and you treasure, that's where your heart is. So if you really love toys more than anything else, or you really love money, or you really love things and stuff, if that's what you love most, are things down here, then your heart's going to be down here. But if what you love most is the Lord, if you love God the most, then your heart is there in heaven. So whatever you love the most, whatever you treasure, That's where your heart is. The second thing Jesus said was to always put God first. Always keep your eyes on the Lord. And then the third thing he said was, only one thing can be most important in life. Okay? Only one thing can be most important. Lots of things are important. Toys are important. Friends are important. Family is important. But only one thing can be most important. Okay? Only one thing can really control our lives. There's only one thing we can really put first. Okay? So Jesus said, three things. Whatever you love the most, it's where your heart is. He says, keep your eyes on the Lord. He says you want to put God first. There's only one thing can be first. And then he said this. He said, therefore I tell you, do not be anxious. Okay? Anxious is another word for worry. Jesus doesn't want us to be anxious. He doesn't want us to worry. He says, therefore I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink. Okay, now, a long time ago, people didn't have as much money as we have. They didn't have as much food. They didn't have grocery stores. They didn't have McDonald's. They didn't have Burger King. And it was a very hot, dry land. And the people wondered, what are we going to eat? What am I going to feed my children? What are we going to do? And it's hot, and I need something to drink. And that was important. Okay? Food is important. Okay? Whatever you worry about is important. If it wasn't important, you wouldn't worry about it. Whatever you worry about is important. And if it's important to you, it's important to Jesus. Jesus doesn't want you to worry about it. Okay? Food's important. He doesn't want you to worry about it. So that do not be anxious about your life, what you'll eat or what you'll drink, nor about your body, what you'll put on. We have to have clothes. It got cold at night. It got cold in the winter. During the day, it was really hot. You needed something to keep from being sunburned. So clothes are important. Tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you'll eat or what you'll drink, nor about your body, what you'll put on. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? So he's saying that food and clothes and friends and pets, all these things are important, but some things are even more important. And that's what we're going to talk about this week. We're going to be talking about those things that are really important, those things that are even more important and the things we worry about. This is what Jesus said. He said, look at the birds of the air. You know what an intersection is? An intersection is where two or more roads come together. Okay? In an intersection, you've got lots of cars. Lots of cars, lots of traffic. Well, the land of Israel used to be called the intersection for birds. There were lots of birds in Israel. Okay? A lot of birds lived there. But also a lot of birds would fly there, coming up from Africa, going up through Israel, go around the mountains. Other birds would come down, headed on their way to Africa. Plus, Israel is right there next to the Mediterranean Sea. So you have a lot of sea birds. So there were lots of birds all over the place. The Bible tells us about some of the birds in Israel. I'm going to list some of them. Eagles, osprey, falcons, hawks. Ostriches. Did you know there were ostriches where Jesus lived? Seagulls, nighthawks, pelicans, vultures, herons, pigeons, dove, turtle dove, sparrow, swallows, cranes, roosters, hens, and chicks. That's just some of the kinds of birds that the Bible mentions. There were lots of different kinds of birds in Israel. Jesus says, just look at them. Just look at the birds of the air. They neither sow, nor reap, nor gather into barns. Now back then, if you were gonna plant wheat so you can make bread, you didn't plant each seed because that would take too long. You need a whole field of wheat. So they would throw the seed, they would cast it. It's called sowing. And every farmer would have to go out all day sowing seed. And then you'd have to wait for it to grow. And when the wheat grows up, then you'd have to get something called a sickle. And you'd have to go in and you'd have to cut it all down. And you'd have to, they call that reaping. And you'd have to harvest all that wheat. And you'd have to bring it in and bring it in the barn. And Jesus says, look at these birds. They don't have to do all that work the farmers do. Okay? Now, Birds have a lot of work they have to do. Birds stay busy looking for food, but they don't have to do the kind of work that farmers have to do. You have work. Maybe you've got to clean up your room. Okay, you've got to help your mom or your dad or your grandma. Or during school time, maybe you got to go to school or you've got to do homework. You have chores. You've got to take care of your pets. So you've got your work to do. Farmers have their work to do. Birds have their work to do. But birds don't worry. Like you've heard the expression, free as a bird. Birds don't worry. Jesus says, look at those birds. They don't worry. And they stay busy, but they don't have to do the kind of work that you and I do. Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow, nor reap, nor gather into barns. And yet your Heavenly Father feeds them. And God takes care of the birds. And then he says, are you not of more value than they? Jesus says, you're more important than birds. Birds don't do the kind of work you and I do. And God takes care of them. Jesus says, you're even more important than birds. So there's no reason to worry. We need to work hard. We need to do our best. But Jesus doesn't want us to worry. Because if God is your Heavenly Father, he'll take care of you. If you're one of God's children, he'll take care of you. We need to work hard and do our best. But if God is our Heavenly Father, he will take care of us. Okay, we're going to be learning more about that this week. But we're also going to be learning a song together. This song is called Children of the Heavenly Father. And it's going to help us understand what it's like to be a child of God, what it's like to have God as our Father. It's a special kind of song. It's called a hymn, which is a special kind of song that's written for us to sing in worship. Okay. And also, a hymn is a special kind of song that's written so everybody can sing. Okay. Some songs are hard to sing, but a hymn is written so that everybody can sing. And so we're going to be learning this hymn this week, and this is how it starts out. The first person. Children of the Heavenly Father, safely in his bosom gather. Your bosom is your chest. So what he's saying is, if God is your Heavenly Father, he helps you in close. Okay? It's like God gives us a big hug. God keeps us safe. If you're one of God's children, he keeps you safe in snow. Children of the Heavenly Father, safely in his bosom gather. Nestling bird, nor star in heaven, such a refuge was given. A nestling bird is a baby bird that doesn't have its feathers yet. Okay? A nestling bird can't fly yet, so the nestling bird has to stay in the nest. And what he's saying here is if you're a child of God, and God is your Father, you are safer than even a little bird in his nest. Okay? A refuge is a safe place. What he's saying is if God is your Heavenly Father, he keeps you close, and you're safer and more snug than even a baby bird in his nest. Okay. Mr. Fuller is going to play this first verse on the guitar so we can hear what it sounds like. And Brendan and Chase are going to sing along with Mr. Fuller. So they'll just do the first verse and we'll just listen, okay? So let's listen. Learn. help us to understand what it means to be children of the Heavenly Father. We ask your blessing in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, I need the puppets to stand up. Miss Mary is going to lead the puffins. You're going to go back to the fellowship hall.